thing.
Yeah. You want me to leave, right? Is that what you're saying?
You got that right.
We will fight terrorism with terrorism. Do you understand?
Well, I'm invited to join the gentlemen's club, and it's not signed by anybody. So I don't know what that means, Lance.
I don't know what it means either. I do know this. We're looking forward to seeing you in action.
From behind, Ox Brody.
Brian Christopher being helped out with Stephen Dunn and Paul Diamond. Thank them for coming in.
Right after the Commandant, here comes Tank and Recon
to finish him off. They shake hands
in a heck of a match. Whoa! Uh-oh. That is not going to win any friends right there. Tony, mad at the outcome. He had it going.
Welcome in, wrestling fans. USWA Championship Wrestling. Michael St. John here, a little disheveled, and here's the reason why. Lance Russell is in the back today, and Lance Russell is...
Hey, am I here or what?
Here.
I am here! And where is Lance?
Lance Russell.
And where is Miss Stacy? They're Lance, not here, are they?
Lance Russell, fans, is in the back. Dutch Mantell is out here. He says he is going to stay out here.
Yeah, I'm staying out here.
And
Lance Russell, he's in the back. He's complaining. He's pouting. He's the world's oldest baby. Miss Stacy back there is crying because the Dutchman, the man, is out here. Now, she
and
can't take
no,
it. That's not my fault. And if Lance Russell, he's a big boy. He's over 21 years old, and he's not out here, is he? No, he's not out here because I'm here. And you wasn't even here last week.
I was here in Memphis at the hotel,
right,
and two of my tires were flattened. And by the time I had AAA out to change my tires,
two of your tires were flattened.
Yeah,
right?
And I have no idea.
Well, what bad luck to have two flat tires. I'm real sorry about that. But you know there's a lot of crime around. Now, let me tell you one thing. You're going to sit out here today, and you're going to say names. That's all you're going to say. And I'm going to tell the people at home what's going on. What?
Let's find out.
Dutchman, please. We've been all through this. You and me's been up and down the road a long time. They don't want you sitting there. They want Lance and Stacy there, so let's just
go. Well, I can't help what they want. No, Bill, wait a minute. I don't care what they want. I am out here today. Lance and Stacy are not here. Let me tell you one thing, Bill. I know we've been up and down the road, and we got history, baby. We're icons. I know that. But listen, let me tell you. Don't come out here and take it up for him. Is he a better announcer than I am?
I'm not taking up for anybody. It's you. See what that says? It says USWA. It's the brains, the suits, everybody thinks.
I don't care if it says PR.
Everybody else, what, never even. They don't want you here. Now, they're going.
Let me tell you something. Let me tell you something.
Get him out of here.
It looks like you're siding with him. So let me tell you this. You take that little bitty nose of yours and stick it on that little bitty body, and you take yourself out of here. Because you're either with me or you're against me, Dundee, so you better get it straight, and you better get it straight fast.
Hey, that sounds like a threat, Mantell. That don't sound like my
That sounds like a threat?
Sounds like a threat.
Well, like my old granny used to say, if it quacks like a duck and waddles like a duck, it must be a duck. So if it sounds like a threat, it might be a threat. So you take it like that.
Duck now, all right. Look, all I want to do and still want to do is keep you from making a fool of your silly self in front of millions of people.
Now I'm a fool. Are you calling me a fool?
Fits like my grandma used to say, if the shoe fits.
Wait a minute. This is getting out of hand. Let's go to break. I don't want any violence.
You get out of here.
Let's go to break. Let's get Lance.
Let me do my business and you do your business. It didn't happen to you, Dundee.
A child is stolen. The pretender becomes a father and risks it all to reunite a family.
He's nearby. Find him.
All new Pretender tonight, then. The confrontation with Jack you've waited for.
Jack.
No more running. No more waiting. No more hiding.
Jack's got her.
Time is of the essence.
Everywhere we went, Jack had been there first.
As Sam tests her courage against serial killer Jack in a special two-hour thrilogy event.
I'm the deadliest of my kind.
All new Profiler, NBC tonight.
People have asked us, what makes a great steak sandwich? Well, it all starts right here, in America's heartland, where everyone knows it's all in how you slice the beef. Thin, real, Hardee's new tender steak sandwiches, sliced thin to be tender and juicy. There's the Philly steak, the deluxe, and even a steak and egg breakfast sandwich. Hardee's tender steak sandwiches. What will they think of next?
For those who go the distance, the start is critical. That's why Exxon Superflow races to protect vital engine parts at the start when significant damage can occur. Superflow has a unique formula offering protection that's fast, protection that lasts.
No one has a more sophisticated communication system than we do, where you can use your phone, fax, and computer in ways you never could before. Unless, of course, someone else is always on the line. Well, now is the time to order another phone line from Bell South, because we're giving you a $40 credit off your bill. Call now.
Hi, Dad.
Order as soon as you can.
Paula.
Bell South. It's all here.
We're back on the USWA, ready to go with our opening bout today, scheduled for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. Introducing already in the ring, wrestling out of the trailer park, weighing 240 pounds, here is Trailer Park Trash. His opponent, soon to be making his way to the ring area, wrestling out of Indianapolis, Indiana, weighing 227 pounds, Flash Flanagan. One fall, 10-minute time limit, down to Michael St. John.
Thank you very much, Tony. Downtown Bruno, your referee. Lance Russell in the back, and you, what are you doing out here? You've already caused problems.
Listen, I'm a man of my word. I said what I was going to do. I said I was going to be out here, and I don't think physics lies, does it? I'm sitting right here. Lance Russell's not here. Miss Stacy is not here. And you're trying to blame me. Don't blame me about nothing, Michael St. John. You know what? You don't even need to be here either. Did you drive down this morning or last night?
I was here in town this morning, and I got to the show today, but I didn't last week, and I'm still trying to figure out why my tires are flying.
Now, we see Flash Flanagan in the ring when I see.
I'll do the commentating. You just do the color.
Okay.
I'll do the commentating.
Then we'll see who's better. Okay, we'll just sit here, and I'll one-up you every time, Jack. Look at that.
Hip toss on Trailer Park Trash and a standing drop kick. You know, Flanagan's had his little problems with
Flanagan.
Billy Travis.
Yeah, he's got a lot of problems, and he's going to have a lot more, too. Let me tell you one thing about Flash Flanagan. He's going to do moves just like that, and his guy's going to move, and he is going to break his neck on the floor. And then who's he going to blame? He's only going to blame himself because he's got he's brain dead. He's got brain lock
Flash
to start off with. He won't do that to Billy Travis.
Flanagan has the guitar in the corner. That's what counts. Possession is 9/10 of the law. Flanagan has Billy Travis's guitar in the corner, and Flash Flanagan has the upper hand
on
that situation.
What you're saying is he's more than a thief.
He has the upper hand in the match. He's got the upper hand in the guitar.
Well, he may have the upper hand in the match, but he's wrestling Trailer Park Trash. He's not wrestling Billy Travis. He's not wrestling Dutch Mantel. He's not wrestling any other guy. He's wrestling Trailer Park Trash. Who, by the way, the last time I looked, his one loss record wasn't outstanding. It wasn't just blazing, screaming at you that he has won so many matches. He hadn't won a lot. Wait a minute. We got a visitor here. We got
Billy Travis coming across.
We got Billy Travis with us right now. Talk to me, Billy. Don't talk to this jabroni.
One thing. Billy Joe's real low right now. I had a very special surprise today. I was going to sing a very special hit song today. They've had so many cards and letters wanting to hear me sing. But I'll tell you what, the thief that man is, he stole my guitar.
He's a thief.
He is a thief in the night, as much as I have done for him.
Actually, he's a thief in the daytime.
But this is going to be a special song. They said the ratings have shot sky high. Because Billy Joe was going to sing today.
But how can you sing without a guitar?
No guitar. Listen. No guitar. Thief, 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 thief.
That's exactly what he is. Michael St. John, he's a thief. He stole it. He's out of
trying
to take that possession.
He's not intense with a suplex off the top rope. Flash Flanagan victorious in stylistic flash. Look at this. Billy Travis has grabbed the guitar. and is running around the studio.
Well, he needs to grab it. He needs to grab it because it belongs to him to start off with. He is Miller.
Wait a minute, Flanagan. Flanagan's going right after him.
Look
He's going
idiot.
Right after him into
Look
the dressing
idiot.
Room.
Look at that man. I told you he was brain dead. I told you he's suffering from brain lock, and he goes right in there, and he goes into hostile territory. A bad, bad mistake because, you know, some of these guys, they do things without thinking. Obviously, he did that on the spot.
Flanagan.
Look at it.
Now being tossed over through the opening of the doorway where the wrestlers come out, and Flanagan is down on the floor.
See, that's what happens to you. That's what happens to you when you suffer from brain deadness.
Billy Travis had no right to be out here. Flanagan was in his match, and now
well,
the
I guess
man's
he had a right
to
go back in
guitar.
There. Did he come out that entrance?
No,
he went
didn't.
Out through there, right? And he's laying there right now. I think it is great. This is one of the greatest days of my life to see Flash Flanagan laying there. A thief, and he gets exactly what he deserves.
We'll find out.
If he was in an Islamic country, they'd cut his
enough,
hand off.
Enough, Dutch, enough, enough.
Well,
enough.
They would.
We'll
he
find out what's wrong with Flash Flanagan. Let's take a break.
A
we'll be back with more
here.
Wrestling action in just a minute.
Won't you read up on some Dutch, cultural diversity?
My sister and I do everything together. We even share a car.
A Chevy Camaro.
We picked it out, but our dad told everyone that he did. He likes the Camaro's airbags.
One for each of us.
He also likes the no lockup brakes.
And the low price.
Dad's always trying to borrow our Camaro.
And when we go out with friends, we always take our car.
Everyone thinks it's cool.
We wouldn't drive anything else.
Experience the Chevy Camaro. Only at your Mid-South Chevy dealers. Every year, they come to the Lone Star State to pay tribute to one of the greatest players in the history of golf and win the tournament that bears his name. From USA Sports, the GTE Byron Nelson Classic on USA.
Get cable installed by May 21st and you're entered to win a trip to see the Atlanta Braves in June.
Be here officially, but it is at Sonic. We're bringing back all of our summer favorites, fun drinks and desserts, guaranteed to make you smile. Just look at our dessert menu. It's totally fun.
Right now at Sonic, our single topping sundaes are just 99¢.
I think it's gonna be a great summer. Let the fun begin.
Depression is just where you don't think you're ever going to get happy again. You don't see the light at the end of the tunnel.
When you're ready to get help, Charter is here, and you can call us anytime.
Charter isn't just a hospital. There are outpatient services, evening and day programs, not just inpatient. Together, we'll find the best program for you.
Sometimes you have to face reality to make things better.
If you have a problem with depression or alcohol, don't wait to call. If you don't get help at Charter, please get help somewhere.
Back with you on USWA Wrestling, Michael St. John. Lance Russell is in the back, fans, and things have gotten off to a horrible start thanks to this man, Dutch Mantel, now King Reginald over here.
I want to say, man, right quick. Look, I'm the world heavyweight champion. Y'all get this, I'm still the world heavyweight champion. I was robbed. You know I was robbed, right? Now get this low budget out here. Let me beat him up right quick.
Let's go to the ring. Here's Tony with the introduction on the
We're
match.
Ready for more action. Scheduled for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. Introducing first from parts unknown, weighing 240 pounds, Mr. Wrestling. His opponent, weighing 280 pounds, the former unified champion, here is King Reginald. One fall, 10 minutes in time.
Nice matchup between King Reginald and Mr. Wrestling, who comes into the area with some outstanding credentials, and I guess we'll see the opportunity for Mr. Wrestling as he'll challenge King Reginald. Controversial, to say the least, in this match. One fall, 15-minute time limit. Downtown Bruno, your referee. Before we get into this match, we want to say hello to the folks here in the studio today from the Unity Church of God in Christ that are here today. Good having them here. And also, some of our studio audience today will receive some food coupons, compliments of Hardee's. Come in and try the new tender steak sandwich, available now at your local Hardee's. Bell time in action is King Reginald against Mr. Wrestling. I apologize. Lance Russell says he will not come out as long as Dutch Mantel is here. Lance is in the back, and hopefully before the show is over, we can get Lance out here so he and I can work together
on the people to death.
Come
so
on.
You and him can really work on super boredom.
You know, this is getting, I'm getting a little tired of it myself.
I don't care, get tired. Why don't you leave too?
Right now, look, right now we see Ken Reginald. Now he is a former world heavyweight champion. Let me say this. It took Jerry Lawler, the so-called king, forever to take the title back. It took him forever. If he had something I wanted, it wouldn't take me long to take it. Let me say that.
In the match right now, Mr. Wrestling against King Reginald, and Mr. Wrestling coming into the area with outstanding credentials, a true tactician in the ring. This man can go to work on a man in the ring and take him down and win a match.
You know,
he is a true tactician.
Michael, you've listened to Bob Costas too much or something. You're trying to say tactician, you're trying to say strategy, you're trying to say all these things. What wins wrestling matches is guts and determination, drive, commitment, and desire.
And I have
That's
no doubt of that.
That's what wins. Wrestling matches. Sometimes you don't even have to be that good of a wrestler, but if you persevere and you hang in there and you got some guts, you're a man, you stand up for yourself. But I see right now when you stand up for yourself around USWA, then you get tons of heat on you. You get a lot of people mad at you. And then when you pulled your little stunt that time, and you never have apologized for it either, by the way, but I wouldn't accept it anyway. But let's get back to the match. They don't have nothing to do with nothing right now.
Thank
we
you
see
very
King
much.
Reginald locking up.
I'll do this part, thank you.
Oh,
all right, King
goodness.
Reginald with a side headlock on Mr. Wrestling, who reverses it into a standing wrist lock. Now, there is strategy and there is tactics in the wrestling ring, and there you saw tactics reversed by King Reginald by pulling the mask of Mr. Wrestling.
You saw a move and you saw a counter move. That's basically what you saw. Now, if you want to try to sit back and analyze it and pick it apart, you're beating your brains to death. Just watch these two guys lock it up. Let them go like two bulls at each other. Let's see who the toughest guy is and see who stands in there the longest. Now, these finesse moves are all great for the fans, but see, they're high-risk maneuvers, and it has a tendency to backfire on you.
I've seen you use the same maneuvers in the ring, Dutch. I mean, honestly, you're a legendary wrestler. I got to tell you,
boy,
I'm a little upset
I can't believe you're
right
saying
now.
That.
I got to tell you, I'm a little upset with you right now, but in the past, you've done some great things in the ring. And right now, you're going against what I've always heard you preach and say. What's going wrong with you?
Nothing's going wrong with me. What's going wrong with USWA management is what I'm saying. And now Lance is mad, Stacy's mad, they won't come out here. I don't care. But right now, we see Reginald. Oh, this is your part, I forgot. You call this.
King Reginald going to work on Mr. Wrestling. Has him with a headbutt, backed into the corner. Going to bring him across into the third table, across the way. Here comes King Reginald. Flying across. Oh, my goodness. What a stupid move. What a great move by Mr. Wrestling. Stepping out of the way.
At least he had sense enough to get out of the way. Get out of the way when something's coming at you at 20 or 30 miles an hour. Wouldn't you move or try to move?
And he did. And Mr. Wrestling now going to work on King Reginald, shaking up after going into that turnbuckle phase first. Body with a boot coming in.
Now, that was a good move by Reggie. What strategy was that? That was just reaction. That was reaction. Was that strategy?
Mr. Wrestling catches him. Small package. This could be it. 1, 2, 3. He got it. He got it. Victoriously, Mr. Wrestling over King Reginald. And again, showing what this man has come into the USWA with. A lot of finesse and a lot of strong resume behind him. He takes the victory over King Reginald, if you would, the former champion.
Well, that's exactly what he is, and that's why he's a former champion, because he doesn't think. But what I'm saying is it took Lawler forever to win the belt back from King Reginald. And tell me about Lawler. How great is he now? He's slipping, brother. He's lost all his skills.
Enough of you, Dutch. We got some great matches coming out, coming on, if you would. Jeez, he gets me so upset, I don't know what I'm saying. We got some great matches coming up throughout the USWA territory. And Tony, I know you've got some information on it. Let's go with you.
Indeed we do. The USWA on tour coming up all over the place. We return to the Lady Luck Casino this Wednesday night. West Helena, Arkansas. It says Tunica, Mississippi on the screen, but it's actually West Helena, Arkansas, Wednesday night, May the 14th, 8 p.m. Just there last Wednesday night. Had a great time. The Lady Luck Casino's Pavilion. Jerry the King Lawler, Too Sexy, Brian Christopher, Bloody Ox Brody, The Truth Commission, The Movie Star, Mike Samples, Flash Flanagan. The list goes on and on. this Wednesday night, May the 14th, 8 p.m. at the Lady Luck Casino in West Helena, Arkansas. Moving along from there, we are going to be Collierville, Tennessee. Friday night, May the 16th at the Collierville High School, 7:30 p.m. The first ever stop on the citywide tour. It's the Collision in Collierville, and the USWA Express is going to be rolling into town Friday night. May the 16th, Collierville, Tennessee. Michael, it's going to be a huge card. I know you're looking forward to it.
We got a great sports team from Collierville over here from Collierville High School. Right there they are.
The wrestling team from Collierville High School is here today enjoying USWA Championship Wrestling, and they will be on hand this Friday night, 7:30 p.m., 6 days and counting, Collierville, Tennessee, Friday night, May 16th. Moving along from there, we are going to be in Parsons, Tennessee, Saturday night, May 17th, 7:30 p.m., 1 week from today, Riverside High School, Jerry the King Lawler, King Reginald, Queenie, the Birdman, Coco Beware, King Mabel, and a whole host of others, all signed, Parsons, Tennessee, Saturday night, May 17th, 7:30 p.m. Then from there, we return to Blytheville, Arkansas, Friday night, May 30th, at the National Guard Armory. Great wrestling fans all in the Blytheville area, Michael.
Absolutely, and plus those folks up in the Boot Hill of Missouri can come on down and see some great action in Blytheville at the Armory coming up on May 30th.
There is nothing like seeing the USWA live when it comes to your area. Coming up next, we're going to take a look at the movie star Mike Samples in action. Stay with us. We'll be back right after this timeout.
What do you say, Bobby?
All the cars and covered by Chrysler's big sale.
It is big, Bobby. All minivans and all Chrysler Sebrings are on sale from $15,995. $15,995 for either a 97 minivan or Sebring, both with air, stereo, and more. On sale from $15,995, now at Covington by Chrysler.
Bobby, let me see. Oh, look at this really high price.
That's our nearest competitor, Janet. Here's where you should be looking.
Covington Chrysler, Covington, Covington
Dennis Hall's Auto Salvage, home of a million parts. Call or come by 3100 Gill Road and see Dennis Hall's large inventory of both domestic and foreign parts. Bumper-to-bumper body parts, used and rebuilt engines and transmissions. They also specialize in both new and used glass replacement for all makes and models of cars and trucks. For steering column and theft repair, Dennis Hall's guarantees the lowest prices in Memphis.
Hi, I'm Dennis Hall. For the best prices in town, come on down.
People have asked us, what makes a great steak sandwich? Well, it all starts right here, in America's heartland, where everyone knows it's all in how you slice the beef. Thin. Real thin. Hardee's new tender steak sandwiches. Sliced thin to be tender and juicy. There's the Philly steak, the deluxe, and even a steak and egg breakfast sandwich. Hardee's tender steak sandwiches. What will they think of next?
If you're just settling in with your brand new computer system, you're going to need some place to put it that won't take a megabyte out of your wallet. At Oak Express, this 48-inch Manhattan desk is only $159. The Internet Computer Work Desk is $248, or Oak Express's Random Access Desk is $299. And everything is in stock, factory assembled, and ready to take home today. Oak Express, 4207 American Way between Getwell and Perkins, and 5248 Summer Avenue.
Are you looking for luxury at an affordable price in your next car? Then come on over to Lumina, loaded with extras. Chevrolet's premier sedan offers room, comfort, and for a limited time, $750 cash back. And Lumina comes with a fuel-conscious 3.4-liter V6 engine, dual airbags, front and rear stabilizer bars, and powered door locks and steering. So come on over to luxury, quality, and affordability. See the new 97 Lumina only at your local Chevy dealer.
What's a flurry? It's the big new thing at Sonic this summer. A flurry is this amazingly cold drink. It's like a float, only blended. We'll even make it with our slushes. Now that's cold. The orange slush flurry is my personal favorite.
Right now at Sonic, try one of our new flurries for just 99 cents.
We've been having fun all summer.
Flurries are totally cool. Kind of like the car hops here.
USWA Wrestling is brought to you in part by Bill Blake Insurance, now with a new location at Getwell and Rhodes.
John, back with you here on Championship Wrestling. Hopefully Lance Russell will be joining us in a few minutes. He's not coming out as long as you're here. Oh, boy. I understand that movie star Mike Samples has some words he wants to say. Let's get Mike out here. I got a feeling this has to do with the situation you've been involved in with the Truth Commission, perhaps.
Well, you're exactly right, Michael St. John. I got to tell you, a couple weeks ago, I was out here and had a little little thing, I guess is the best way to describe it without doing language here that I can't air on TV, with the Commandant, and then out came his goon squad, and I got to tell you, they won't let me forget it. I've been trying to forget it. It was just one of those things that happened a few weeks ago. Commandant was gone. I offered to step in, help his guys, and they had a little problem. He blamed it all on me, and I quite frankly got to tell you, I'm not going to take the blame for it. I can't help it if those guys can't think for themselves. That's not my fault. That's his problem. He can take care of them from now on. And I've been thinking, you know, Mike Samples has come out here a lot of weeks and done a lot of things, and one thing I'd like to do is have myself apologized to right here on TV by the Commandant for what happened here a couple weeks ago. And I know a way to do it. First off, I didn't come out here to talk to these idiots out here in the audience so they can shut up and let me talk. I would like the Commandant to come out here right now. I have a proposition, and just him by himself, if you don't mind, not the goon squad. I'd like to have just the Commandant. I have a proposition, and this will all be over.
All right, let's see if we can get the Commandant. Well, here he comes. Here's the Commandant.
If you don't mind, come out here.
No.
There won't be any problems here today. You're a fairly intelligent person, I can tell, by talking to you, by some of the things you've done. I can see that you're the brains behind that organization. Unless you and I bury this hatchet, and I don't mean in each other's back, let's bury this hatchet that's between us because, you know, quite frankly, sometimes it's just us against all the rest of the, like these idiots over here in the audience, it's us against them. So let's get this all behind us. I know that you are the commander of the Truth Commission, and two of your guys are the USWA tag champions, and that's no problem. That leaves one man, the big man, Tank. So I have a proposition, if you can accept it on his behalf, because I don't want him out here causing any problems, let he and I have a match somewhere this upcoming week in some of the arenas. Let him and I have a match. If I win, then I want you to be man enough to come out here next week on TV and apologize to me. But if he beats me fair and square, I'll come out and apologize to you. That's all I want to say. Can you do it or not?
I have absolutely nothing to apologize to you for, number one. But secondly, if you would wish to face my man Tank, that would only be a pleasure, Mr. Samples. And I promise you that you will be the one who will make the apologies for what you did to my team.
Well, that's fine. If he beats me fair and square, I'm man enough to come out here on worldwide TV and apologize, but I'm asking you, are you man enough to come out here and say, Mike Samples, you were right and I was wrong, because I got to tell you, I don't think Tank can beat me.
Sounds like a fair proposition.
I know Tank will beat you into the dirt, and that is the truth.
Is that a deal?
Fair and square?
Fair and square.
All right.
In the ring?
In the ring.
I accept, Mr. Samples. I accept.
Well, would you like to shake on it? Great.
As an officer and a gentleman.
Certainly a unique proposition, I must say, between you two.
Well, I have a match now. You make sure that you're in the back and Tank's in the back watching, because I want you to see just exactly what Mike Samples can do.
All right, there you have it. A little agreement with Mike Samples and the Commandant. Let's go to the ring for the introductions on this match.
Thank you, Michael St. John. We're ready for another one today on the USWA, scheduled for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. Introducing first already in the ring area, weighing 250 pounds, wrestling out of Hollywood, California, the movie star himself, here is Mike Samples. His opponent, wrestling out of Clarksville, Indiana, weighing 224 pounds, Nick Pinsmore. One fall, 10 minutes in time.
Nick Pinsmore against movie star Mike Samples. Interesting little proposition by Samples.
It sounds like a lot of apologies may have to be given out here. Did you see how I conveniently stayed out of that?
And it sure was good, because I could conduct you to let the men do their talking.
That's right. Well, I don't stick my nose where it doesn't belong, like you do, like some other people around here do. You know, you tuned in late, fans. Bill and D come out of here and try
it. Dutch, don't start on that. Come on.
He took your side against me. That's like wrestler taking management side. It's just not, you know, it's supposed to happen. Mike Samples here teaching this young Nick Densmore a lesson, which he should have probably learned before he showed up on this wrestling arena today. He should have knew when he come down here and he messes with some men.
Well, Mike Samples is a tough wrestler. He is a veteran. He knows what he's doing in the ring. Nick Densmore is a newcomer. He's got a very good opportunity to make a name for himself right now. He is a talented young man, but he's going to have to learn. You had to learn when you first got into the business.
No, I never did have to learn. I knew it from the beginning.
Scotch, come on.
When you say he's talented, he hadn't done nothing much. Mike Samples manhandled him all over the ring.
It's very easy with Lance Russell.
Good move by Densmore now. You know, Samples, he may make a mistake about this. You can't underestimate too many of these guys because they can embarrass you right here on television.
And Densmore going right after Mike Samples. Got his short arm bar right now.
Is Lance still around?
Lance is still in the back.
They're telling you from the control booth?
They told me.
Stacy's still around?
Stacy's in the back. She's not coming out either. I mean,
she's not coming out.
She's not.
Ellen did. Maybe she's a little more happy than we think.
Lance, if you're listening.
Stacy's not coming out.
Lance,
well, you said it.
Come on.
You said it.
I would sure be.
Maybe she should come out. You know, I don't like Mike Samples calling these people idiots here. I think imbecile would suffice.
Oh, come on. Mike Samples right here is going to get the pin quickly.
Wait a minute. He got the win, but
here comes some more visitors.
Let's see what this is going to be good.
This is Tank and the Commandant out now with Mike Samples.
Is this the best you can do against that monkey? Look at you, man. You're a sorry excuse of a wrestler.
What are you doing out here anyway, huh?
Wait a minute. Whoa.
Hey.
Look out.
Ever refer to us or talk to us in that tone of voice. Do you understand? Hey. I promise you.
Elliot Mays is coming out. Hopefully to break this out. Get him out. The commissioner, Elliot Mays, is out here.
Keep him away. What do you mean?
Tank and Mike Samples locking up. Elliot Mays and the Commandant. Let's see if I can get over here.
You don't get your guys acting right. You're out of here. Now get him out of here.
Out of here, you mean what?
Right now, out of the studio. I want him out.
And if I don't?
Then you're going with him.
What do you mean gone?
You're out of the USWA. And I mean now.
No,
I'll give you. Get him out of here.
Of Elliot Mays, the commissioner from the USWA. It's Mike Samples being attacked by Tank. Mike, the worst for wear. He got the victory in the ring, but after that, the little agreement between Tank and, or make that between the Truth Commission, if you would, and the Commandant and Mike Samples may be off to a little rocky ground here.
I think he is.
Oh, my goodness.
I didn't do it.
See how I stayed out of that?
Thank
I don't
good
have nothing to do. I'll stick my nose in other people's
thank
business.
Thank good we restored some order. Let's take a break. Where are we here? We'll take a break. We'll be back with more USWA action in just a moment.
Just announced by Ford. The Great Percent event is back at your local Ford dealer. And that means your choice of low 1-9 financing for 48 months or big cash back on America's favorite cars. Get 1-9 financing or 500 cash back on Contour. Get 1-9 financing or 1,000 cash back on Taurus and Thunderbird. Even get 1-9 financing on the all-new ZX2. The choice is yours. Big cash back or 1-9 financing. So don't miss your chance to take advantage of the Great Percent event only at your local Ford dealer.
Take your food dollar to the max at Maxi Foods. Enjoy deep discounted specials like these. Boneless chuck roast, 99 cents a pound. Greens, 4 for $1. Jiffy corn muffin mix, 8 for $1. Sour salad dressing or mayonnaise, 99 cents each. And Pepsi products, 99 cents per 6-pack. Enjoy maximum savings and customer satisfaction at Maxi Foods. Now at 2 locations, Winchester at Mill Branch and 3rd at Rains. Take your food dollar to the max at Maxi Foods.
Looks like an egg beater. It's a baby shaving. Yeah, two elephants kissing. It's Gandhi, and he's doing that Heisman Trophy thing.
When you eat a big, juicy Rally's barbecue bacon burger, you pretty much forget about everything else. If it doesn't get all over the place, it doesn't belong in your face.
It's home cover-up time at Curlow Construction, and it's your chance to uncover big savings on the improvements your home needs. Right now, save up to $300 on Curlow's best 20-year asphalt fiberglass shingle roof. Save up to $800 on low-maintenance weather-beating siding. Call this number right now for a free, no-obligation home improvement estimate. And with 100% bank rate financing and no money down, Curlow has you covered. Take advantage of home cover-up specials from Curlow Construction, Memphis' number one home improvement company.
Ordinarily here in the segment on championship wrestling, ordinarily here in the USWA, we have a new feature that came, was introduced last week, and the fans, the reaction was tremendous this past week, so we're going to go to that feature.
Letters?
Stacy is here and was supposed to come out and have a little feature here called Wrestling the Way It Used to Be.
And that's the name of her segment.
As we debuted last week.
Well, this is the way wrestling used to be. No women around. That's the way it is right now. So, really, I'm doing wrestling the way it used to be.
Come on,
she's not here. No women around.
A very, very strong
segment.
And I think, and I'm stalling for a little time here because I think we've got a camera set up in this control room because Stacy is back in the control room. She's not coming out for the same reason Lance Russell isn't coming out. And I got to tell you, as more of the show goes on, the tougher it gets to sit here with you. But anyway, we've got a great segment, and I think you fans will enjoy this. Wrestling the Way It Used to Be with Stacy. Stacy, take it away.
First of all, I'd like to thank everyone who called in and said they enjoyed last week's segment, Wrestling the Way It Used to Be. And even though Lance and I aren't in the studio today, I wasn't going to let Dutch Mantel stop us from seeing this week's segment. And Dutch, I had to go back to 1982 to find this match. I hope you enjoy it, Mr. Mantel.
Dutch trying to sap the strength out of Jerry. Back to the ropes, and that'll call for a break. And Lawler comes off the ropes with an elbow. Two right hands. Reversal by Mantel. Sleeper hold again. Referee. As Lawler slumps to the canvas. Dutch hanging in. <laughs> 19 minutes in. Still trying to hang on. Lawler trying to fight back. Elbow rips him out of that sleeper. But Mantel right back with a right hand. Comes after Lawler. Reverse. And now Lawler with a sleeper hold. To wrestle. 20 past 40 to wrestle. 20 minutes in. Lawler and Mantel start to unload on it. The Dutchman on the floor. This is a mighty tough customer he's in there with. He drops with that big fist. And if Jerry wants that belt, now he's going for the pin. One. But Dutch reverses. One. Two. And Lawler kicks his way out. Drop kick and Lawler over to the ropes. Dutch coming right in on him very fast. Sunset flip, Dutch down. He's out at the count of one. And Dutch misses a drop kick. Waller grabbed the ropes and held up. Some of that smart savvy that Waller has. And they both go down. We're about 22 minutes in, 38 minutes to wrestle. Dutch coming up from his knees. And Mantell backdrop, a chain, dropped down on the floor in the center of the ring. Lawler grabs it. And he bangs Dutch, drops it outside. One, two, three, and that's it. The new Southern Heavyweight Champ, Jerry Lawler.
And there you see, wrestling the way it used to be. Great new segment here on USWA Wrestling. Jerry the King Lawler showing what helped make him the legendary, the king, Jerry Lawler.
And that's what you get. They got to show. A lot of them show nothing that he loses here. He's got to show that.
Jerry the King Lawler.
That's low, brother. That is low.
Jerry the King Lawler making his way into the studio here on Championship Wrestling. His way around the ring. Great crowd on hand today. Jerry the King Lawler, one of the most popular wrestlers to ever come into the sport of professional wrestling. About the enthusiastic crowd or about Lawler being one of the most popular wrestlers to ever. And the King, Jerry Lawler.
Hey, brother, that's low.
What?
That's low.
What's low?
Showing that?
What? I didn't show that. I had nothing to do with that.
Your little friend that Lance calls Tracy, you don't even know her name, she shows it. I think it's low. You know it's low. You just won't admit it, brother.
He's been this
that's
way.
That's low.
I don't know what you're talking about, Dutch. I enjoyed watching the old clip there. You know, it brought back some fond memories. I even saw Dutch Mantell throw a drop kick. He threw one drop kick that connected, and then you people saw history. You saw the last drop kick that Dutch Mantell ever threw in his entire career there. I thought it was fun, Dutch. What's the matter? What's the problem?
It was fun, but you know it's low, and you can't say it wasn't. It was low, Daddy.
Hey, give me a break. Listen, I just want to say a little word about the match that I heard here last week against a young guy by the name of Tony Williams. Now, you know, I don't sell anybody short that steps in the ring, because anytime you step in there, anything can happen. You can be beat by anybody. And this kid gave me a heck of a match. I wasn't pleased with what happened after the match was over. He gave me a couple of cheap shots. And so he contacted Elliot Pollock, the commissioner, and asked for a rematch. So I was more than glad to oblige him here today on TV. The kid's a good young wrestler, and so we're going to see if he can maybe be a little bit more of a gentleman here today, see what we can do. And Dutch,
it's going to make you more of a gentleman. That's going to take some doing. You know, hey, Tony Williams almost kicked your butt all over this place last week, so now you're going to try to take him on again to redeem your name. Is that what it is? You know, you do a low thing, then you take some.
What did I do? I didn't do anything, Dutch.
Forget
what's his
it.
Problem?
Forget it.
Well, let's go to the ring.
That was low. He knows it's low. He's lower than a whale. He's low down.
Let's go.
We are set to go. More action today on the USWA. A rematch from last week, scheduled for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. Introducing first, wrestling out of Memphis, Tennessee, weighing 217 pounds, Tony Williams. His opponent is the reigning unified heavyweight champion of the world, weighing 242 pounds from Memphis, Tennessee, Jerry the King Lawler. One fall, 10 minutes in time.
This match coming up as a result of what happened last week and as a result of what happened after the match last week.
What he did, he bruised Lawler's ego. He bruised his ego because he went out there and he did some stuff that Lawler didn't expect him to do. Now, you know, what Lawler said was right. You may sell people short. I bet he's not selling him short today. So let's see how much fire, let's see how much desire and commitment that Lawler has today on television right here today to redeem his name, so to speak. And I'm saying that.
Tony.
I'm saying he's here to redeem his name.
Tony Williams, most likely overmatched this week as he was last week.
Look here. That Tony Williams today. Now, Tony Williams is going to try to make a name for himself today. He's going to try to make a name. So if he can get out here and embarrass the King, and I'm going to tell you what, you know how long it'd take me to beat Tony Williams? It'd take me about 30 seconds to a minute to beat him.
That Lawler, you see Lawler's coming out here and all these morons, people getting behind him here, and I don't understand that. I do understand it to a degree, right, because he's been around here longer than water.
Big scoop slam, and down
time
goes
he starts
Tony.
Doing something. He's going to have to show Tony Williams that this is not going to be a cakewalk. I think Tony Williams' confidence got built up and his self-esteem got built up during the week, but he wants it to...
Watch, you're being paid.
Oh, shut up, Lawler. Won't you worry about him? Don't worry about me. You want me to... Hey, you want me in there, buddy? Huh?
Tony Williams locking up Tyler Neville, and Lawler picks him up and drops him on his back. Lawler right back up. Tony Williams' legs beginning to wobble as he picked the king up for the slam. If he's planning to make a name for himself using Jerry Lawler as the scapegoat, this is not the direction that I would take or that I would recommend.
See, he don't want none of me. He don't want none of me. You could melt Lawler like butter and pour him on me. And I'm saying that from me to you, substitute announcer, and that's all you are, Marcus St. John, a sub.
Jerry Lawler in the ring. Dutch, I'm just going to ignore you.
You know what you are for wrestling journalism? You are for wrestling journalism of Pablo Escobar as to the DEA. That's exactly what you are.
Lawler and Williams locking up collared elbow. Lawler scoops him again. Oh,
look
nice
at that. Tony Williams embarrassing the king. Embarrassing you, Lawler. He's in. Come on, Tony. Stay with him, brother. Stay with him. This is your time. This is your time.
Lawler a little bit wild.
I'd have done a wipe this kid out.
I don't know if Lawler...
I'd already erased it.
I don't know if the king is more riled than Tony Williams or more riled than what you're saying. There's a big back body drop, and Williams to the mat. Lawler moving in.
He's going for it again.
That's that flip. One, two, and a count of two. Tony Williams with a quick two.
Taking it to the limit. Like the Eagles say, take it to the limit. Tony Williams taking it to the limit.
Lawler already.
Hey, if this crowd don't shut up, I'm going to come out there and I'm going to slap every one of them. Why don't you shut up? Hey, you want me in there or what? I'm tired.
Wait a minute. Dutch Mantel picking up Shoe Baby and going over to the ring apron. Referee Downtown Bruno over to intervene. Now Mantel stalking the ring. Tony Williams, wait a minute. Wait a minute. Tony Williams has Shoe Baby, and it's got Lawler from behind, and he's choking him with that bullwhip. Dutch Mantel is over on the ring apron, going from the desk here to talk with Downtown Bruno and distracting Bruno as Williams does the dirty work on Jerry Lawler. Is this some kind of conspiracy? What are you getting involved in? Right now, Tony Williams with the upper hand on the king. Lawler taken into the turnbuckle. Is this some kind of conspiracy? What are you doing getting involved here? If you're going to be an announcer,
I'm not. Hey, remember, y'all removed me here. This Tony Williams now taking it. And he's not doing nothing Lawler didn't do for about 15 years of his career. He's a low-down dog then, and he's a low-down dog now.
The difference is if you were over there in the corner distracting the referee, Tony Williams off the top rope, Lawler out of the way, Williams falls to the floor. One, two, three.
Well, he made a mistake, but he took him a long way, and this has redeemed the king's name.
Jerry Lawler takes care of business with Tony Williams. Well, the fans could see and the folks at home could see what happened thanks to the distraction by Mr. Dutch Mantel. Tony Williams going toe-to-toe with the king, but Jerry Lawler victorious in this match here on USWA Championship Wrestling.
There he is, Tony Williams, took him to the limit. The king's trying to redeem the name. To me, he failed the test miserably.
Dutch Mantel. Oh, I don't know what's gotten into this guy, but whatever it is, let's take a break. We'll be back with more USWA action right after this.
At the Happy Hawker, you'll find all kinds of merchandise at incredible savings. If you like to pay reasonable prices when you buy jewelry, diamonds, musical instruments, cameras, TVs, VCRs, tools, and guns. If you're the kind of person who really searches for just the right gift at just the right price, then you may make a great pawn shopper. Need cash? See us for the lowest rates on loans with the area's only drive-in loan department. Visit either Happy Hawker location, 975 East Parkway South, or our new Superstore at 299 North Cleveland.
Can I have your attention, please?
What's up? Hey, what's up?
I got a big announcement to make.
Are we getting new hats?
No, we're introducing fresh stuffed pitas at Wendy's.
Yeah?
Now, Wendy's has pitas in four delicious varieties, like garden ranch chicken, overflowing with crisp vegetables and big chunks of tender chicken.
Really fill them up.
Chicken Caesar with shredded parmesan and two veggie pitas, classic Greek with feta cheese, and garden veggie.
These are great. Yeah,
come in and try Wendy's new fresh stuffed pitas.
So that hat thing's not going to happen?
No.
You know, I've been in Memphis a long time. Bill Blake Insurance has, too. If you have never checked out the hometown boys at Bill Blake Insurance, then you're missing a Memphis tradition. Respect, service, and good value is part of doing business at Bill Blake Insurance.
I've been doing business with Bill Blake Insurance for years. He's always there when you need him, and you only have to make one payment per month.
I sing the blues all over the world, but I always come home and I always see the hometown boys at Bill Blake Insurance. At Bill Blake Insurance, he's from Memphis.
For those who go the distance, the start is critical. That's why Exxon Superflow races to protect vital engine parts at the start when significant damage can occur. Superflow has a unique formula offering protection that's fast, protection that lasts.
Memphis, Tennessee, we're back on USWA Championship Wrestling right here on WMC TV 5, ready to go with more action. Introducing already in the ring, wrestling out of Tulsa, Oklahoma, weighing 285 pounds, here is Scott Reigns. His opponent making his way to the ring area, weighing almost 600 pounds, here is King Mabel. One fall, 10 minutes in time, down to Michael St. John and Dutch Mantel.
Thank you very much, Tony. King Mabel, what a imposing figure entering the ring here on USWA Wrestling, going up against the newcomer, Scott Reigns out of Tulsa, Oklahoma. One fall with a 15-minute time limit. King Mabel with quite a reputation, removing his wrestling garb, if you would. Get ready to get this match underway.
More like removing a tent, taking his tent off. Mabel is huge. I don't know what they announced him at. He's got to be close to 500 pounds. And this kid here from Oklahoma, I think he's in for a real tough go. You see, what's wrong with this kid here? He don't know how to wrestle Mabel. He's got to try to get away from him. He can't match power and strength and size with Mabel. He'll just eat you up. A lot of these guys, they don't try to figure out their opponents. They try to go out there and take their strong suits, but their strong suits might not match up to their opponents. See, he's trying to, that ain't going to have much effect on Mabel, I don't think.
King Mabel, not only being an imposing figure in the ring, he is a man that can move very quickly in the ring when he needs to.
Look at that.
But right now, he doesn't need
to. Look.
Scoop slam Scott Reigns and a big slam.
He planted him like yesterday's garbage. That Lawler, I'm going to tell you, Lawler's a low, low man. That Stacy's probably low as he is.
Now,
where are they still in the studio, too?
Dutch, they're still in the back. I checked during the break.
Care.
You know, things were going, you were talking about the match, everything was fine. If you would do that, then maybe you got a chance of being an announcer. But now you go digressing about Lance and digressing about Law.
Before you came along,
I was asked by the USWA to be here, and I'm here. Mabel,
he had him pinned.
He did have him pinned, and now he just gets up and apparently is going to inflict a little more damage.
You make a stand. You stand up for yourself, and everybody gets mad at you. I'm just standing up for what's right and what's best for Dutch Mantel. Nothing more.
Well, Dutch, I have to ask, are you a wrestler or are you an athlete?
I'm both. I'm multi-talented, which I can say you're not even well-talented in the announcer field.
Dutch, I have been in the broadcast business for 25 years. I'm doing this because the USWA asked me to come and work with Lance, and when Lance is out of town, and when there are events that they want to get together on, and that's why I'm here. Look at that leg whip by Mabel. Whoa.
And he's working around with a lot of power to it. Now, hey, you say you've been in broadcast business 25 years. That don't mean nothing. Dr. Gavorkian, he's been in the medical field for 50 years, but look what he's doing.
I think the best thing is for me to ignore you, and I'm going to continue to do that. And hopefully Lance will be out here.
Whoa!
Belly-to-belly slam, super slam on Reigns. One, two, three. He's not going to get up from that one. And big King Mabel. The power and the strength of a big man, I tell you. When you're a little man, you can try to finesse and you can try to work your way in, but the power of the big man just continues to be dominant here in the USW. And that is Big King Mabel in the ring. He is victorious. Oh, my goodness. What a big man this is. Let's go now to Tony. We got a lot of USWA action coming out throughout the area. Let's get Tony to fill us in on everything that's going on once we get King
Mabel.
We
do have a lot of action coming up. King Mabel, one of the superstars that's going to be making some of those towns across the USWA Tour, like this Wednesday night, West Helena, Arkansas, May the 14th, 8 p.m. at the Lady Luck Casino. The King Jerry Lawler, Too Sexy Brian Christopher, Bloody Ox Brody, The Truth Commission, and a whole host of others. Wednesday night, May 14th, 8 p.m., Lady Luck Casino at the Pavilion. We'll be looking for you down there. Michael, I don't know if you've ever been to West Helena, but there are some of the best wrestling fans up there. We're going to be there every Wednesday night this summer, and it's a great time every time we're heading up there.
Yeah, I want to say hello to all the folks down in Helena, and they made national news, you know, with that little news story this week with that chemical plant, but now this is all being cleaned up, and then Wednesday night, big news coming to town when the USWA comes to town.
Oh, yeah, big news coming up Wednesday night, May 14th, 8 p.m. at the Lady Luck Casino. Then from there, Friday night, May the 16th, Collierville, Tennessee, 7:30 p.m. at the Collierville High School. The citywide tour kicking off with the Collision in Collierville. The USWA Express is rolling into town. Jerry the King Lawler, Too Sexy Brian Christopher, the superstar Bill Dundee, the bad guy Razor Ramon, King Mabel, Dutch Mantel, and a whole lot more, all signed Friday night, May 16th, Collierville, Tennessee, and a very special match. Collierville's own Gerald Emerson will be taking on Luke Kahn from Houston High School right there in Collierville, 7:30 p.m. Friday night, May 16th at the Collierville High School. Saturday night, we're going to be in Parsons, Tennessee. Saturday night, May 17th, Parsons, Tennessee. At Riverside High, Jerry the King Lawler, King Reginald, Queenie the Birdman, Coco Beware. This Saturday night, 1 week from today, May 17th, 7:30 p.m. in Parsons. Then rounding out the on-tour action, we are going to be Blytheville, Arkansas, Friday night, May 30th at the National Guard Armory. We'll be telling you more about that next week. The USWA on tour. Make sure you catch it when it comes to your area. We're coming back with more USWA Championship Wrestling. Stay with us.
A leaky roof can be your worst nightmare, ruining your home's interior and appearance. But a roofing system from Owens Corning can fix the problem for good. Our long-lasting fiberglass shingles, underlayment, and ventilation products work together, so you won't have anything to lose sleep over. After all, there's a system to these things. Owens Corning. Call 1-800-GET-PINK for our free roof troubleshooting kit.
In a city renowned for its art, strokes of brilliance are performed upon a canvas of red clay.
What a point! By the slimmest of margins, that's it.
At this tournament, you don't just out-hit your opponents. You out-think them. The French Open. Exclusive coverage starts Monday, May 26th on USA.
Get cable installed by May 21st and you're entered to win a trip to see the Atlanta Braves in June.
There's a source for all of your words to travel through. One simple, powerful source, Bell South. We're bringing together every kind of technology. Local and long distance, internet access, wireless, yellow pages, interactive and beyond. One single source that connects your words in every way. Because a word can have many meanings, but it means nothing until it's shared. Bell South.
Arby's would like to remind you of your local speed limit. This is necessary because it's 5 for $5 time, and folks are anxious to get 5 regular roast beef sandwiches for only $5. 5 helpings of Arby's tender, juicy roast beef you top with your choice of sauces. We expect to see you as soon as the law allows. In Montana, I guess we'll see you a little sooner. Don't miss Arby's 5 for $5 time. And try Arby's homestyle fries, so good they beat McDonald's in a national taste test. from NBC and Hallmark Entertainment.
I want you to defeat the Trojans.
He had the courage to challenge the gods.
You cannot stop me!
And the passion to capture a goddess.
No one comes or goes from my island.
The greatest epic adventure of all time.
Your destiny is to become immortal.
Armand Asante, Vanessa Williams, and Bernadette Peters. An epic story comes to NBC. The Odyssey, coming Sunday, May 18th.
Action News 5 packs more sports into each minute than any other station. Harold Grater's got all the weekend's highlights, the big plays, and more. Sports Sunday, only from Action News 5.
They've had to do a little remodeling at Pizza Hut headquarters since their co-founder came out of retirement to become a Papa John's franchisee. See, he thinks Papa John's makes better pizza than even the company he helped found. Today, Frank owns over 40 restaurants.
Papa John's. Better ingredient, better pizza.
He's got it.
Papa John's.
Hey, looks good here.
Get a large one-topping pizza for just $7.97. Add a six-pack of Coke in cans for only $1.97.
Sports coverage you can count on today on Action News 5.
The fans are speaking. They're making their thoughts known here. The fans want Dutch out of here. And wait a minute, here comes superstar Bill Dundee. I wish he'd see superstar Billy coming out here. Mr. Dundee.
I hate to just come out barging out here because I was brought up better. Now, I got a few minutes. Mr. Mantell, if you'd just stand up a minute. Your grandma had an old saying, and my grandma had an old saying. We've come to all that. Well, let's just, you and me, not wait no longer. Do this the old-fashioned way. Haul it up in the ring right now. Come on.
What are you so hot about?
I'm still hot at just some of the things you said.
Come
on.
Wait
it wasn't me that started this. I tried real nice to reason with you. It's USWA.
Come on, Bill.
And you made it personal. So let's just do it the old-fashioned way.
I didn't make nothing personal with you.
You did.
No, I didn't. I'm not getting there. Listen.
He wants you in the ring.
Don't even, I'm not going to go in there today. Look, he gets on fire. He's an idiot. He's from Australia. I'm not coming in there, Dundee. I'm not coming in there.
You were the one that set him off at the opening of the show.
Come here. Now, get him down here. Come here. Come here, Dundee. Come here, man. Now, come here.
Superstar Bill Dundee coming back out of the ring.
I don't want to wrestle you today. I know we both lose our temper sometimes.
You're the one that said, I put my little nose in your business. Well, why don't you come punch it? I'm giving you the opportunity. Come on. Your grandma talks a lot, so did mine. Said the real things. It was true. The old-fashioned way is always the best way. You know that. Come on, let's get it on.
Look out! Dutch Mantell from behind with the heel of that bull whip, and he's going after Dundee. Wrapping the shoe baby around Dundee, and they're going at it on the floor. Bruno, can we get this broken up? Dundee and Mantell going at it like two fierce animals. Here comes Stephen Dahl out of the dressing room. Paul Diamond's out there. Flash Flanagan, Mantell, and Dundee. Mantell provoking this earlier in the program today, and now when Dundee challenges him to get in the ring, Mantell rushes him from behind. Now here comes Tank from the Truth Commission. Brockus is out here trying to keep these two apart. Here they go again. Get them separated. Goodness sakes. Dundee and Mantell are going at it. There's seven wrestlers out here, and they're trying to keep these men separated as Dutch Mantell and superstar Bill Dundee. Dundee provoked by the remarks of Mantell on the program, comes out to challenge him in the ring, and then Dutch Mantell with that bullwhip. Boy, when you see Dutch around, he's always got Shoe Baby at hand, and today, I am at a loss for words. The fans showing their displeasure with Dutch Mantell. Wait a minute. Wait a minute, Dutch. What's wrong?
Oh, he's a low-down dog like all of them. Hey, I don't back down from nobody, Dundee. If you want to play the game, if you want to get down, you want to get dirty, You picked the right guy to play it with. So anytime, any place, you want to get this on Dundee, I got something waiting for you. So you come on, and you get a good dose of it.
Dutch Mantell, Bill Dundee, they obviously have a problem between them now. Let's take a break. Let's recompose ourselves. We'll be back with more after this.
Is it home improvement time at your place? If so, turn to the Mid-South's home improvement leaders, Curlo Construction. Let the professionals at Curlo cover your home with beautiful, easy maintenance siding. Next, let's install energy-efficient tilt sash replacement windows. They're easy to clean and beautiful. Call this number for a free, no-obligation home improvement estimate. And with no money down and 100% bank rate financing, now's the time to call Curlo Construction. At Curlo, we're improving Memphis, one home at a time.
Are you hungry?
Yeah. How about something different?
I hear they have pitas at Wendy's.
I'm hungry.
Yeah, me too. Let's go to Wendy's and try the pitas.
In case you haven't heard, Wendy's has fresh stuffed pitas. Like our Garden Ranch chicken with big tender chunks, chicken Caesar with shredded parmesan, classic Greek with feta cheese, and our delicious veggies.
Where should we eat? I don't know.
They have pitas at Wendy's.
Thanks, Dave.
It's everything you love, stuffed in a big, warm, soft pita.
We're selling lots of pitas, Dave.
Word gets around.
Come on in and try one today.
You know, I've been in Memphis a long time. Bill Blake Insurance has, too. If you have never checked out the hometown boys at Bill Blake Insurance, then you're missing a Memphis tradition. Respect, service, and good value is part of doing business at Bill Blake Insurance.
Buying car insurance can be confusing, but not at Bill Blake Insurance. They can answer all your questions, and you only make one payment per month.
I sing the blues all over the world, but I always come home, and I always see the hometown boys at Bill Blake Insurance. At Bill Blake Insurance, he's for Memphis.
Lens Crafters has a new lens, DuraThins. Watch this. Compared to regular lenses, DuraThins are lighter, they're thinner, they're 10 times more impact resistant and almost twice as scratch resistant. Huh. You won't find DuraThins anywhere else. And at Lens Crafters, we can make them in about an hour. They're comfortable, they're safe, they're durable. They let me help people to see better.
Wow, much more comfortable.
New DuraThins, only at Lens Crafters.
Lens Crafters is now open in Wolf Chase Galleria, located at I-40 and Germantown Road.
Last night we had USWA wrestling action in the Show Me State of Missouri in Caruthersville at Casino Astar, and in a big battle royal up there, some interesting things had to shape up, I guess. They shaped up, nevertheless, between Paul Diamond and Brian Pillman, and we want to take a little look at the action that happened last night in Caruthersville, Missouri at the Casino Astar. To Paul Diamond in that match, and flying Brian Pillman takes it away and smashes it right in the middle of the ring. Pillman just losing it, as you see, and I'm sure we haven't heard the last of that between Brian Pillman and Paul Diamond. Wanted to show you that little snippet from Casino Astar. Let's go to the ring now for the introduction on this next match.
We are set to go. More action today. One fall with a 10-minute time limit. Soon to be making his way to the ring area, wrestling out of Swan Pond Bottom in Lake Cumberland, Kentucky, 285 pounds. Here he is, Bloody Ox Brody.
What happened to Dutch Mantell?
Huh? Dutch Mantell.
Well, let me tell you something. I'm here to take over the USWA, and by God, I'm going to start today.
Bloody Ox Brody.
Bloody Ox Brody making his way to the ring.
Wait a minute, hold on a second. Brody going after the announcer in the ring. Holy cow, here comes Elliot Pollock, the commissioner of the USWA out. Now he's going after referee Downtown Bruno. And here comes Steve Dahl and Flash Flanagan. Let's see if we can get over here and get the conversation between Elliot Pollock and Bloody Ox Brody. I don't think I can get that far over. What is going on here?
I don't know, Mike. We got to take some control over these guys. There's something bad going on here.
Elliot, thanks for coming out here. Boy, that was out of hand. He went after our ring announcer. He goes after the referee. Tony's down on the floor, or was on the floor over there. Oh, my goodness. So let's try to get some order restored here. Oh, my. Bloody Ox Brody. What is going to happen next here? We got Dutch Mantel going crazy. We've got Bloody Ox Brody in the ring going crazy. Oh, Lance. Lance, please come back. Let's take a break. We'll be back with more action after this.
People have asked us, what makes a great steak sandwich? Well, it all starts right here, in America's heartland, where everyone knows it's all in how you slice the beef. Thin. Real thin. Hardee's new tender steak sandwiches. Sliced thin to be tender and juicy. There's the Philly steak, the deluxe, and even a steak and egg breakfast sandwich. Hardee's tender steak sandwiches. What will they think of next?
5, 4, 3, 2, 1. The season is here. Braves baseball excitement is coming at you. And Fox Sports South has it. The heavy hitters, the monsters on the mound, the World Series contenders. 25 live games only on Fox Sports South. Major league action like never before. Home teams, Fox attitude.
Get cable installed by May 21st and you're entered to win a trip to see the Atlanta Braves in June.
Dennis Hall's Auto Salvage, home of a million parts. Call or come by 3100 Gill Road and see Dennis Hall's large inventory of both domestic and foreign parts. Bumper-to-bumper body parts used in rebuilt engines and transmissions. They also specialize in both new and used glass replacement for all makes and models of cars and trucks. For steering column and theft repair, Dennis Hall's guarantees the lowest prices in Memphis.
Hi, I'm Dennis Hall. For the best prices in town, come on down.
I couldn't get out of the car. I hurt my back and my neck. My back was really hurting for about 3 or 4 months.
Car accident? Make one call, that's all, to Caddy Keltner, Bienville, and Montesi.
I called the other guy's insurance company, and they blew me off. I needed somebody who knew how to take care of a case, and they did.
Call 526-2126. We know the ins and outs and can help you get your check quickly.
When he gave me that phone call, I was very relieved.
Car accident? Call Caddy Keltner, Bienville, and Montesi. Make one call, that's all.
Main event time coming up here on USWA Wrestling. And this match with specific consequences here. Steve Dunn and Paul Diamond will take on the Spellbinder and Brockus. The winner of this match has been guaranteed a match at the USWA against the USWA Tag Team Champions, the Truth Commission. So this match coming up right now with Stephen Dunn and Paul Diamond against the Spellbinder and Brockus. If we can get them out here and get it underway. I also want to apologize for the craziness around here today. It's been a little disheveled, but we'll try to restore some order and get things going for the rest of the show here on Championship Wrestling. And by the way, fans, we appreciate your viewing, and Lance Russell will be back, if not later on in this show, hopefully next week, to rejoin us once we get this controversy over with Dutch Mantel. And there's Spellbinder and Brockus making their way into the studio right now, getting ready for their confrontation against Paul Diamond. It's Steve Dunn. The winner of this match will get a shot at the USWA Tag Team Championship. And Dutch Mantel is back out here.
You know where I've been?
No, I don't know where he's
been. I've been looking for Bill Dundee. He's already left the building. I've been in the back looking for Bill Dundee. He's gone. And I hear you fumbling, mumbling around. I hear you miss me out of here. You can't do it by yourself. If I'd have found Dundee, I'd have broken right in half. I'd have had two and a half foot pieces laying on my hands. He's only 5 foot tall.
Dutch, you got your own problems with Bill Dundee. We've got a wrestling match coming up right here. The winner of this match, this has some very important consequences because the winner of this match gets a shot at the USWA Tag Team Championship belts, which were one of the most prestigious belts in the United States and in the country for championship wrestling.
Didn't you already say that one time?
Well, I'm just sure that you understand.
You're redundant, too. You're redundant. You say the same thing over and over. Okay, let's watch this match here. Diamond and Dunn. They want to be champions. So do Brockus and Spellbinder. And they're all great athletes. Don't get me wrong. They're all great athletes, but they're wannabes. All of them.
We're ready. One fall with our TV time remaining here. And starting for his team will be Stephen Dunn, and he'll go up against
Bill. Let me tell you one thing about that commissioner, too. He's going to stick his nose in somebody here. Somebody's going to slap him, too. There's a lot of chaos today around the USWA headquarters right here. A lot of people hollering at other people, and a lot of things are going on. And that's in the back. When I was running around looking for Dundee, there was guys looking, and they were screaming. They were hollering in the back. So these guys are fired up here in the USWA. Can't quite put my finger on it, but something's going on here. There's an undercurrent. There's an undercurrent of rage right here in USWA right now. Now, a lot of people, I guess you want to blame me for that, too. You blame me for everything else. Blame me for that, too, because I can take it. I can take the blame. It rolls off me.
Well, I'll tell you, you've been a catalyst for a lot of the problems.
No, I stand up for myself. Right now, we got Barker's, a big, huge German monster, Stephen Dunn. They don't know how to handle this guy. This guy is awesome. Look at his arms. His arms are bigger than your head, Michael St. John.
Double drop kick. I think they just handled him. Big double drop kick, and there's one for Spellbinder coming in the ring. Paul Diamond and Stephen Dahl going right, or Stephen Dunn rather, going right after these two big men. And I'll tell you, that's one thing about when you take on men that are bigger in size and stronger in demeanor.
Tell that to Bill Dundee when he takes on me.
Well, you have to use a little.
Tell that to the superstar.
You have to use a little ring savvy, and that's exactly what Paul Diamond and Stephen Dunn are doing so far in this match. And again, the consequence of this match, the winner gets a shot at the USWA Tag Team Championship. So the importance of this match underscored with the products of these four men in the ring. Brock is going into the corner. Diamond backing out of the way, bars the arm.
Barker has a $1 million body. He's got about a 10-cent brain. He doesn't think a lot. This is a thinking man's game. I'm sure in broadcasting, you are required to think at times. Aren't you, Michael St. John?
Absolutely.
You are required, right?
Absolutely.
Be any more different. You're required to think in football and basketball, and actually you're even required to think a little bit in track and field. So why would wrestling be any bit different? But Brockus, you know, he's so big he relies on his size and his strength. Sometimes he makes silly mistakes.
Stephen Dunn going for the cover after a nice leg trip by Paul Diamond. Look at the teamwork by Diamond and Dunn in there. They got Spellbinder, double whip into the ropes. Duck Runner now, Dunn with a right hand, and Diamond with a big knee lift. Spellbinder turned around in the ring. Nice drop kick by Dunn, cover by Diamond. One, two, Dunn and Diamond. It sort of just rolls off of you. I think they have a, you know, like winners, Kentucky Derby winners.
What?
Kentucky, kind of,
what are you
no,
talking
these people,
about?
They, these Kentucky. People, they name their horses, they name their athletes. You have names like Michael Jordan sort of rolls off your tongue. That's what I'm saying, Dutch. And these men have a magic about it. Dunn and Diamond. It just sort of rolls off. Don't you agree?
Oh, I guess. Dunn and Diamond. A magical, magical deal. Maybe they'll pull a rabbit out of my hat neck. I don't know. You know, Michael Dunn, I have absolutely no idea what you're talking about, but don't try to explain it anymore. You've already confused me enough, as well as the hundreds of thousands of fans out there.
Brockus right now.
And they put you
Paul
in
Diamond.
My place? I cannot believe it.
Diamond whipped into the ropes. Oh, catches the rope.
Another mistake. I'm going to tell you, Dunn and Diamond, they better take advantage of Brockus' inexperience right now. They better see if they can go ahead and take him out now, because they can't match strength with him. They can't match size with him. So they're going to have to really work together. Now, they're working pretty good together as a team. I'll say that. They finally got a little smarter than Brockus.
All four men in the ring right now with Brockus and Spellbinder.
Up we got company. We have visitors.
The Truth Commission hitting the ring. Now, what are they doing in here?
They're fighting everybody.
They're going up everybody.
Ring a bell. We got chaos
referee
here.
Downtown Bruno's call for the bell. What is the Truth Commission doing in here?
I'm moving out of the way.
Amazing that these four monkeys think they have a right to fight for the title? What right? My three men will sort out all four of them on any given day. Please, these are apologies of wrestlers.
Go on, hey, I'm in the ring.
I don't care what Commandant says, they're still going to be better. He better pull his men here. They're the champions, and, you know, I question the rationale of the whole, why would he even say that? I don't know, maybe they're mad about them.
He better get him out of here before Elliot Pollock comes out here and tosses him out of the USWA.
Right. We are the title holders, and that is the end. Stand down! Stand down! You proved your point!
The match called a no contest, obviously, by referee Downtown Bruno. As you say, we had company in the ring with the Truth Commission. Spellbinder and Brock is there. I think everyone is confused in here. This has been a very, very confusing day. Let's take a break. We'll be back. We'll try to sort all this out. We'll be back with more.
There'll be no sorting this
after
one.
This.
This is out of hand now.
A leaky roof can be your worst nightmare, ruining your home's interior and appearance. But a roofing system from Owens Corning can fix the problem for good. Our long-lasting fiberglass shingles, underlayment, and ventilation products work together, so you won't have anything to lose sleep over. After all, there's a system to these things. Owens Corning. Call 1-800-GET-PINK for our free roof troubleshooting kit.
Looks like an egg beater. It's a baby shaving. It's two elephants kissing. It's Gandhi, and he's doing that Heisman Trophy thing.
When you eat a big, juicy Raleigh's barbecue bacon burger, you get hours of free entertainment. If it doesn't get all over the place, it doesn't belong in your face.
A word can point you in many directions, depending on what it means. That's why Bell's South is here to help you find your way. We have the people, the knowledge, the expertise to guide you through new technology, to solutions that work for you. Always with answers that keep you and your words connected. Because a word can have many meanings, but it means nothing until it's shared. Bell's South.
Seen enough? Want more? We've got all the beauty and challenge you can handle, and then some. 18 championship courses across Alabama, overseeded to be green all year. Paula DePerna in the New York Times calls this some of the best public golf on earth. Call 800-949-4444 for golf of a lifetime. Alabama's Robert Trent Jones Golf Trail. So great, it's addictive.
All right, back with you here on USWA Wrestling. We want to talk about everything that's going on around the USWA, and we'll go to that in just a moment. I got Kevin Christian right now, and Kevin, I think we're going to have him run down the USWA cards, and then we're going to talk about Collierville in a little bit.
Great.
All right, Tony, take it away.
Michael St. John, USWA on tour, kicking off this Wednesday night. West Helena, Arkansas, the Lady Luck Casino. Had a great time up there last Wednesday night. We're going to be up there this Wednesday night, May 14th, 8 p.m. Look at the stars on this one. It's going to be a star-studded night of action this Wednesday night, May the 14th, 8 p.m. at the Lady Luck Casino in West Helena. Friday night, Collierville, Tennessee, the Collision in Collierville, 7:30 p.m., Collierville High School. Look at the stars on this one. The King Jerry Lawler, Too Sexy, the Bad Guy Razor Ramon, King Mabel, the Superstar, the Dirty Dutchman, and a whole lot more. And the USWA Express will be rolling into Collierville this Friday night, May 16th, 7:30 p.m. at the Collierville High School. Saturday night, May 17th, Parsons, Tennessee, at the Riverside High. Jerry the King Lawler, King Reginald, Queenie, Coco Beware the Birdman, and a whole lot more. Parsons, Tennessee, 1 week from today, Saturday night, May 17th at 7:30 p.m. Then from there, May the 23rd, we're going to be in Crockett County High School in Alamo, Tennessee. It's not on the screen this week, but May the 23rd, Crockett County High School in Alamo, Tennessee. We'll tell you more about that next week. And then Blytheville, Arkansas, Friday night, May 30th at the National Guard Armory. The USWA on tour. And Friday night, Collierville, Tennessee, Michael St. John standing by with Kevin Christian. Tell us all about it.
All right, the bus is going to be rolling. The big USWA Express making its debut in Collierville this coming Friday. And Kevin, tell us about it and how to get on that thing.
Okay, well, like I said about the USWA Express, we just have a few seats left. And this afternoon, myself along with Tony Freeman and Too Sexy Brian Christopher, we're going to be out at Blimpie's. Blimpie's of East Memphis is right around where Poplar and Colonial meet. And if you still want to get on the USWA Express, this is going to be your last opportunity to do it. So you need to come on out to Blimpie's of East Memphis.
Now, as I understand it, you get to ride the bus. You get to go to the matches. There are videos on the bus. There'll be some USWA stars. You get the whole, if you would, the whole shebang.
If you want the whole shebang, you get it for just $15. And one thing you forgot to mention is it also includes a free frozen yogurt from our good friends at Blimpie's. And like I said, I don't know what it is about this frozen yogurt gets everybody excited. But anyway, speaking of the Collision in Carnival, which is this Friday night, May 16th, the first stop ever on USWA's brand new citywide tour. One of the special matches that we're going to have that night, Tony got a little tongue twisted earlier, but it's going to be Gerald Emerson from the Carnival High School Dragons. He's going to be in an amateur wrestling match against Logan Kuhn from Houston High School. And speaking of the Carnival Dragons, we happen to have a few of them here in the audience today.
Yeah!
Check
Dragons. All right, very good. Well, that is all coming up this coming Friday night.
May 16th. I want to remind everybody, come see myself and Two Sexy Brian Christopher and everybody this afternoon.
Come step on the side here. Ladies and gentlemen, big announcer, Billy Joe found his guitar. He's going to sing today. And let me tell you, nobody sings a love song quite like I do. Well, maybe Lucio Iglesias and Luther Vandross.
Who?
You know who they're Iglesias. Ladies and gentlemen, listen up. I am so beautiful to me. Had you seen, I'm everything I hope for. I'm everything I need. I'm so beautiful.
The studio. Now that's an encore if I've ever heard one. Wow. My ear was beginning to. I think I've lost some hearing in the left ear from that song. With Flash Flanagan expressing his displeasure. Billy Travis singing. Oh, I think I've heard it all. After hearing Billy Travis, I know I've heard it all. Flash Flanagan and Billy Travis. They still have a little. Conflict to, oh my, I can't hear after hearing Billy Travis in my ear. They still have a little conflict to figure out and get strained out. It's Billy Travis. I hope we've heard the last of him anyway. All right, well, fans, I want to recap the action. Let's see if we can. Do we have time for a second fall? I'm trying to see where we're going here, but let's recap the action real quickly here this afternoon. Flash Flanagan opening match, he got the victory over Trailer Park Trash. And then in the next match, you saw Mr. Wrestling victorious over King Reginald. Mr. Wrestling coming into the area with some strong credentials. Jerry the King Lawler gets a win over Tony Williams, although Dutch Mantell had to throw his 2 cents into that one. You saw Bloody Ox Brody sort of toss everybody around. And then in the big main event, Stephen Dunn and Paul Diamond against Spellbinder and Brockus. And I tell you, these two teams went at it, but unfortunately, the Truth Commission had to come out and disturb things. The Truth Commission, of course, have the USWA Tag Team Championship belts, and they will be putting those on the line. And I guess the USWA and Commissioner Elliot Pollock will have to sort things out and see who will get the title shot, either Steve Dunn, Paul Diamond, or the Spellbinders in the shot at the belts. Dutch Mantell, I want to apologize to the fans that Lance Russell, he was in the back today, but because of a little problem with Dutch, he said he was not coming out here until Dutch left the studio. And of course, Dutch made his presence known throughout the program today with a little confrontation with Bill Dundee and with Jerry Lawler and a little bit of everybody else. Tony, I tell you, this has been one, I've been on many a wrestling show, but this has been one for the books as to what happened out here today.
Michael St. John, this has been one of the wildest days I've ever seen since starting with the USWA some time ago. I want to remind everybody else to watch us next week. Commandant out here with Michael St. John.
Well, obviously, we've still got a little time. Here's the Commandant. You've probably got something you want to say.
I would just like to remind those people, how dare they demand a title shot? Who are they to go behind our backs demanding a title shot? I beg your pardon. We are the champions. And we proved here today that my three men could handle those four anytime.
Now remember, you have an open contract with the USWA. They can sign a match with whoever. You have to wrestle whoever they sign you to wrestle.
We will take them on anytime, anywhere.
All right. The Commandant making his thoughts known. All right, that's going to do it, I think. Tony, thanks for helping out here.
All right, great day,
man. On behalf of Lance Russell and Stacy, Michael St. John for the USWA. We'll see you back here next week.
The announcers on this program are selected and paid by parties other than this station. mainly the promoter.
The Odyssey, tomorrow on NBC.
Jill, there's still more TNBC.
On USWA Championship Wrestling.
Two of your tires were flat, right?
Yeah, and I have no idea.
Well, what bad luck to have two flat tires. I'm real sorry about that. But you know there's a lot of crime around. Now, let me
look at this. Billy Travis has grabbed the guitar and is running around the studio. What? Now being tossed over through the opening of the doorway where the wrestlers come out, and Flanagan is down on the floor.
I think it is great. This is one of the greatest days of my life to see Flash Flanagan laying there.
If he beats me fair and square, I'm man enough to come out here on worldwide TV and apologize. But I'm asking you, are you man enough to come out here and say, Mike Samples, you were right and I was wrong?
Tank and Mike Samples locking up. Elliot Mays and the Commandant. Let's see if I can get over here. You're looking at it. Tony Williams has you, baby. And it's got Lawler from behind and is choking him with that. Trying to keep these two apart. Here they go again. Hello, everyone. Welcome in again to USWA Championship Wrestling. Well, as you can see, Lance Russell is not here today. Stacy's in the back. Because and only because Dutch Mantell is here today, unfortunately. But I'm sure we'll be hearing from Dutch shortly. But in the meantime, I got to tell you about a card of action today on Championship Wrestling that is unbelievable. First off, for the first time that I can ever recall on television, there will be a chain match today on television between Ox Brody, Bloody Ox Brody, and Too Sexy Brian Christopher. And at Ox Brody's request, we have an ambulance standing by outside. You can see it on your screen right now. The paramedics are ready. They've got the stretcher ready. The chain match will be here today on television between Bloody Ox Brody and Too Sexy Brian Christopher. And just in case, Bloody Ox Brody wanted that ambulance out back, and we've got it right here at the studio here today. Also, Jerry the King Lawler will be in action. Billy Travis has promised us an unplugged concert. His quote-unquote concert got interrupted, rudely interrupted, I might add, last week. But anyway, Billy Travis will be here for that. Plus, for the USWA Tag Team Championship, 2 out of 3 falls between the new champions, Steve Dunn and Paul Diamond. They'll take on the Truth Commission. Dutch Mantell has made his way.
I told you I was going to be here. Lance Russell is not here. And why is he not here? Because I'm here.
And now, Dutch, I'm not going to take any of your stuff today. You're here. We know you're here. Let's sit down and get on with it.
This is going to be an exciting show. There's going to be some big, big surprises. If Stacy's here, I got something for her. And she's going to wake up and smell the coffee and listen to what I got to say. Shut up over there. I am talking now. But she's going to see something today. I'm going to smarten that girl up.
Well, you've taken over the show for weeks now, and I'm a little tired of it. Let's take a break. We've got a great show of wrestling action despite Dutch Mantell.
I'm here.
Here today.
Get ready. Sunday on NBC, it's Third Rock's Visual Effects Spectacular. A full hour of the biggest Third Rock ever. You won't believe your eyes. The aliens get called back to their planet for 200 years.
What about Mary?
Oh, she'll be dead.
Will Dick go or stay behind?
I want to marry you.
You've never seen anything like this. It's the most incredible visual effects ever seen on television. A must-see Third Rock event. This